Hello Geo Specials, welcome to my channel. In this tutorial, you're going to go through converting the model that you had created in the previous video into a tool. So if you haven't watched that video, you can go right ahead and watch it first, then go come to this. We'll get started with exposing the tool parameters, and we'll go ahead and just go to the tools that we had created in the model builder and right click on each one of them and expose their parameters. So you can start with the make XY extent layer, event layer. Right click on it, make variable, then from parameter we are going to select X, and we are also going to select Y. So again, from parameter, select Y field. Then next, we are going to move to the clip tools and do the same, make variable, parameter, XY tolerance for both of them. Then the project tool will do the same, make variable from parameter, and then we'll need the output coordinate system. And for define projection, we'll go to make variable, parameter, the coordinate system. In the buffer, make variable, parameter, and we want the distance. Then in project, we want the parameter to be the output. Then in the intersect, we'll just put the make variable from parameter and the join attributes. So we can rearrange and align them by auto layering them. As you can see, every tool now has its parameters exposed. Now the next thing we'll do now is create model parameters for these tools. So we'll just right click on every parameter that we have and we'll create models. So right click on the Y and then select model parameter. The same goes to X, model parameter. For every parameter that you have exposed, yeah, like that. Then the next thing we need to do is rename the model elements. So I will need to rename these elements, the, for example, the inputs and outputs. So for example, if we rename this one, you can rename it to something like, you just right click and select rename. You can just rename it to input, input secondary schools, then select OK. Then Kenyan rivers, you can also rename it to input Kenya rivers. Then this one, you can rename it to input county. County file. Okay. So now once you're done with that, we'll also need to go to the last result. And right click on it, and we'll also put it as a model parameter, and we'll rename it to output, then click OK. We can save what you have done so far. Now the next thing we need to do, we can just minimize the model builder. We are going to be setting the model parameters. So to set the model parameters, you'll just go to Arc Catalog, then you right click on your model and then go to properties, then go to parameters. So we are going to set the order of how we want them to appear. So for now, the X and the Y and X are okay. We can just bring the X to the top, click on it and bring it to the top, then the X Y tolerance, then the coordinate system, then the output coordinate, the distance after the buffering, then the output coordinate system. You can bring it to the top, then the join attributes and the final output. The next thing we'll do is set model parameter type. And we can, for example, if you were to select the input Kenyan rivers, we want it to be a feature type of a line. So we'll just click on the type, then filter and select feature class. So we want it to be a line only. So we'll just uncheck the other boxes and leave it as a polyline feature. Then select OK. If it's the county file, it should be a polygon. So select feature class and then uncheck the other boxes and select OK. And for the secondary schools, they should be points. So again, then just select OK once you are done with everything. To set the model parameter type, we'll need to just click on one. For example, if it's optional, and you can choose it to be required or optional. I'll just leave them as they are. So select OK. Another thing that we would like to do is manage intermediate data. And basically, intermediate data is the data that is just used as an input, but it's not the final data that you are going to be using. For example, at the clip, the data that was formed after clipping was the Kajiado rivers that have been clipped, but we are not going to be using this data later. So if we don't want to save this intermediate data, we just deselect this intermediate, but I'll just leave it as checked to save the data. Finally, we are going to be changing the general model properties. Therefore, go to model, select model properties. Then you are going to change the name from the label to schools affected by flooding and give it a description. You'll give it your own description. Then just select store relative path names instead of absolute paths. Then click OK. So once you're done with that, the final thing we'll just be left with is documenting the model. It is advisable to document your model so that if anyone else comes upon it or wants to use it, he or she can get around using it and understanding how it works. So to document your model, go to the tool, the model, then right click and select item description. Then from here, just click on edit, and then you just edit it appropriately. So you just change the title, give it a thumbnail, some tags, a description, then you describe all of the parameters and what they do. Then let us just test if our tool is now functioning well. So click on model on the Kajiado, then click on the model itself, double click. The Y field, X field are okay. We can just set the data to the input of secondary school. It's set to Kenya secondary schools. It's okay. Then the input of the Kenyan rivers, it's okay. Then the county file, let's just change it to another county to test if it's working. So we'll just Nakuru County, then add. We'll select the We'll set the distance, buffer distance, to 1,000 meters. Then the output coordinate system is 37 south, that's okay. The output, the join attributes, it will just leave it as all, then save. Then just select OK and let's give it time to run. Okay, so it has completed it successfully. You can close and see. Let's uncheck the rest. Then we'll just zoom to layer. And here are the schools that are affected by flooding in Nakuru County. So guys, thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. If you really appreciate what I'm doing and you like this kind of videos, hit the like button as well as share. Goodbye.